WDUN. If you want to go and take a ride with me, we'd be willing in the
fall with the goldies. Oh, why? We're approaching a quarter till 7 o'clock here on the Tuesday edition of Game On. I hope everybody's had a great day. More importantly, I hope that when you get home, when you're done with the timely afternoon commute, you take a few minutes to step outside and enjoy this beautiful weather. You can take us with you on your smartphone by downloading the Access WDUN app. So even if you're out walking the dog or pushing the stroller around the neighborhood, folks, you can be listening to Game On with me, Katie B. Davis, and we encourage you to do so. Big news out of the high school football world today, folks. Chastity coach Stan Luttrell has decided to take a position with the Buford City Schools, and he will be on staff with the Buford football team. This sudden news because of the success that Stan Luttrell has had at Chastity, the program he has built there. And so we wanted to get him on Game On tonight to talk about that legacy, but also to talk about moving on to Buford High School. So welcome into Game On, Coach Stan Luttrell. So happy to have you here.
I'm glad to be here, Katie. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. First and foremost, Coach, why the move?
Well, you know, I think when opportunities come up, it's easy to say, well, you know, we've had success here, we've done things, and I'm comfortable here, and pass on opportunities. And then when other opportunities come, I think you know when it's time. And this opportunity just really came out of nowhere and really intrigued me. And one conversation led to another, and it just ended up being the right move for me and my family right now.
Where football is concerned, and really across the board in the sports world, Buford, a very attractive place to athletes and coaches alike. But what attracts you to Buford High School, more importantly, to the Buford football program?
Well, obviously, you know, they've had a tremendous amount of success, not only in football, but in many things, just about everything that they do, they've had success in it, which that's intriguing. But, you know, the more that I got to speak with Coach Simpson and really just saw his heart and his vision for the program and what my role would be within the program, it just really, it was exciting. And you know, I think that, the more that I got to know him, you know, you think that you know someone, but then when you just really sit down and talk to him and talk the ins and outs of philosophy, and, you know, I don't think he would mind me telling you, we had a lot of discussions about Jesus and about the gospel of Jesus Christ and being called to coach and seeing coaching as a ministry, and he and I are on the same page there, and stuff like that really gets me excited, and I wanted to just see what that looks like on the inside, and one thing led to another, and I'm thankful today to be exactly where I'm at, and with looking back on a great 8 years at Chastity, but also looking ahead in a new role and new challenge.
I'll tell you, you're going to be a welcome asset to any coaching staff that brings you on, but being very familiar with the Buford coaching staff myself, definitely a welcome asset there, and we congratulate you on the new position. What is the new position, Coach?
Well, I will be the strength coach at Buford, and I'll be a defensive assistant. Right now, it looks like I'll be helping Coach Appling with the linebackers and working directly with Jess on defense. And you know, the biggest thing is in the weight room and then coaching defense, which most people, you know, don't know that that's really where my roots are. You know, I played linebacker in college and my whole career, and just as a head coach, called the offense and kind of known for the split back gear and that stuff. But, you know, my roots and who I am really started on the defensive side of the ball. So I'm looking forward to getting back to coaching a position and being in the, you know, the daily grind of working kids on the field and developing those relationships that you just can't do or that are hard to do as a head coach. And I look forward to just having a different role and just being another one of the soldiers that any way I can help Coach Simpson and the rest of the staff and the school, I'm looking forward to it.
This might seem like a silly question, but it's one that I want you to address nonetheless. Is the lack of pressure attractive when you go from being a head coach at a program that was really finding its footing statewide? in the Chesity program to one that has solid footing and you're an assistant coach. Did the lack of pressure, was that an attractive part as well?
Well, you know, I tell people all the time that no one's going to put more pressure on me to perform than myself. I really have super high expectations for me and everything that I do, from being a husband or a father or, you know, my role at church or whatever I do, I'm going to have high standards. So I don't think pressure has anything to do with it. What I do think is worthy of mentioning is I've been a head coach for 13 of the 16 years I've been teaching and coaching. I'll be 40 in June. And so a lot of younger coaches are chasing titles, whether it's a coordinator, you know, title, or be the offensive coordinator or defense coordinator, really want to be a head coach. And I'm at a point where I realize that it's much more than just titles. You know, I've had the coordinator title and I've had the head coaching title for many years. And that really doesn't mean a whole lot to me anymore. And so, I'm looking forward to just being an asset to Buford football and Buford High School and that community and just having a different role, but still having super high standards and making an impact.
Very well said. We're continuing our conversation on this Tuesday edition of Game On with former Chesity football coach Stan Luttrell, who is taking his talent to Buford, where he will be part of the football coaching staff there, as well as part of the Buford City school system. Let's go to Chesity now, Coach. You built this program from you just did great things with it, and including the first state playoff win this past season. Built incredible young men there as well. What do you hope is the legacy that you're leaving?
Well, I think one sign of great leadership is that it doesn't leave when you leave. And, you know, I think we've got a good group of coaches that remain at Chesity, and several of them are worthy of an opportunity to be the next head coach there. You know, Bill Foreman, Matt Mays, John Brimer, those guys have been right there with me in different capacities throughout the years. And so it'd be my hope that what we've done would just continue to grow and continue to get better. You know, the 8 years at Chesity from the day that Bill Thompson hired me until today are years that I'm going to look back with a lot of fond memories and knowing that I did everything I possibly could do to make that the best football program it could be, as well as, you know, build young men and truly understand the role of high school football. And so it'd be my hope that they would continue to grow, continue to get better, and I'm going to be a fan of these players and that program as long as I'm around. And there's a big decision to be made by our leadership as far as who the next head coach would be, and I'm sure they'll do a great job in selecting him.
You just mentioned the phrase fond memories. I want to take it one step further as we wrap up here, Coach Luttrell. Are you proud of what you did at Chesity?
Absolutely. And maybe a better put is I'm so excited about what God has done through me and my staff at Chesity over the last 8 years. You know, we have been able to do things at Chesity that most people would have never dreamed possible. You know, region runner-up the past 2 years. 17 wins in the past 2 years, you know, playing for region championships and just all the great things, winning all these last second games. And, you know, I think that's a testament to the program. It's a testament to the work ethic and the commitment and all the things that we've stood for at Chesity football for the last 8 years. And so, you know, I'm just excited that I was able to be a part of what God has done in the last 8 years at Chesity. I'm looking forward to see what he continues to do there and really excited about what he's going to do in my life and my family's life in our new move to Buford.
Well, quite proud of you for taking the step needed for yourself, for your family, and best of luck to you at Buford. Of course, I'm going to miss having you on every Friday night to talk about the big wins at Chesity High School, but hopefully Coach Jess Simpson, maybe I can get him to let you on Friday nights here and there as the strength coach and a defensive assistant. How does that sound, Coach Luttrell?
Well, I would definitely cherish those moments. I want to take this moment to just thank you for being such a encourager. You know, the Game On and KDB Davis has been an encouragement to me and our program and my family, And I look forward to those conversations, too. And I can look back with fond memories about looking forward to talking to you and just how you can promote our kids and our program and the big wins that that we've been able to experience together.
You're a good guy, Coach Luttrell, and I appreciate your kind words. We'll be talking to you again soon, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
6:54 as we continue this Tuesday edition of Game On. Congratulations to him. And here's why I say congratulations. Sometimes it is hard to make a move that you know people are going to question. And if you think for 1 second people around here when we got that press release didn't go, head coach to strength coach? Something's fishy about that. You're crazy. But he was ready. Did it for his family. Did it for himself. Wants a different sort of challenge. And I'm excited to see what the Chesapeake community does with that head football coach role. Because Stan Luttrell set a standard there. You know he did. I know he did. He set a standard there. He let that community know they can play with anybody. I mean, they're a couple of turnovers away from beating one of the best teams in the state last year in Monroe area. With a patchwork group of kids. Man, the midget mafia, right? I'm excited to see where Chesapeake goes. And I'm excited to see what Coach Luttrell can do at Buford High School. And kudos to Jess Simpson. Go find yourself some talent. Bring it in. That's what he did. That is absolutely what he did. We appreciate Coach Stan Luttrell being with us this afternoon. Sometimes those conversations can be awkward. Sometimes those conversations can be awkward. He handled it like the gentleman we all know he is. When we come back, folks, we'll hear from Steve Wojciechowski, the new Marquette men's basketball coach. Also, to the starting five. Your social media questions picked at random by my producer, Brian, answered at random by yours truly, Katie B. Davis, during Game On WDUN.